Okay. So Windows decided to update, and I lost the text file that I was keeping l the list of things that I was going to investigate. So I'm just gonna have to wing it and have absolutely no idea what I'm doing. Oh, right, I was going to check out the Quantum Moon. Right, well, as long as I don't crash the ship too bad, I can. Whoop, dang it, wrong button. Just head back in there and do the thing. So I guess they were already here when the Nomai were. Otherwise, there wouldn't be ghost matter inside. Dang it. There's the jetpack refuel. Ugh. That could have gone slightly better. Imagine just flinging yourself around in space and then slamming randomly into that thing. Behold, artifact. I found feldspar. Found feldspar? And they're in Dark Bramble? Stars above, this is wonderful news. Thank you. Thank you for finding them. That feldspar didn't immediately join you on your ship in return here is incredibly feldspar of them. We are never entirely sure what feldspar was thinking back then either. Still, we ought to fish them out of that dreadful place with all haste. I'll radio Gossett and have them prepare a ship. It really should be Gossett who brings Felspar home. Again, thank you. You can hardly imagine how profoundly happy I am to hear they're alive and unharmed. No, thanks, I'm good. That was not drop artifact. So, apparently you can parkour your way out of this. Without a suit. With a suit, it's pretty easy. I'm gonna have to look up how that works. Where's the quantum moon? Quantum moon. I wonder if that counts as a photo. Okay, that's close enough. Tree. So where's that shuttle? All right, there's a timber hearth. The eye. All right, the twins. I do not recall which one you need in order to go north. It is not this one. And it already disappeared. Dang it. Giants Deep. Looks pretty safe. I was aiming in the wrong direction, though. Okay. So now I just gotta find a tower in this area. There's one. All right, timber hearth. Then I go up to the North Pole. And there it is. That's the right texture. Hi. Who are you? Ah, okay. Got it. Who am I? I've never met one of your kind before. It's an honor to speak with you. I particularly admire your four eyes. There are many questions I would ask if I could comprehend your language. You have my gratitude for understanding mine. We are orbiting the Eye of the Universe now, although we cannot see it, only the quantum moon's reflection of it. The Eye is older than the universe itself, and my clan believes it dwells in an extremely distant orbit around this star system. This is the quantum moon, where we both are standing. Despite also orbiting other celestial bodies, the quantum moon is the eye of the universe's moon. I am Solanum, a Nomai. My clan arrived in this star system before my birth, and we now call it home. I am on my first pilgrimage to the Quantum Moon. All now my in my clan make this journey when we come of age. Even though the Eye cannot be reached from here, the Quantum Moon remains special to us, as it carries us nearer to the Eye than any other place we know. I've journeyed here to be close to the Eye. While the Eye is obscured from our sight, we can see the Quantum Moon's reflection of the Eye in the sky above us. There is a fundamental uncertainty throughout the universe. Normally, this uncertainty is only observable on a very small scale. As one approaches the Eye, however, that uncertainty grows enormously. The quantum moon probably exhibits macroscopic quantum behavior because of its proximity to the Eye. Shards that broke off from the quantum moon have a similar effect, as I imagine you've seen elsewhere in this star system. Conscious observation forces a quantum object to collapse to a single possibility. What would happen if a conscious observer somehow entered the Eye itself? Over time, this has become my clan's greatest question. Have you encountered a quantum shard on another planet? The shards look the same as the quantum moon's surface does now, while at the Eye. From this, we can reasonably infer the quantum moon's natural state is as we see it now, and that the Eye is its primary location. Given the quantum moon is the Eye's moon, it's likely that any characteristics the moon exhibits are also exhibited by the Eye itself. The quantum moon and its shards, for instance, are quantum. Thus, the Eye is likely also quantum. In fact, this moon is probably quantum because its proximity to the Eye made it quantum. The same way the areas surrounding quantum shards that have landed on other planets eventually become quantum too. Explain me. I imagine your purpose here is the same as mine, to learn about and to find the Eye of the Universe. I'm unsure how you arrived here, however. Perhaps you came from another star system, as my clan originally did? Aha, there it is. This should be inside the tornado, right? Yeah. Absolutely nothing here, though. Why Brittle Hollow could be exited here. Probably because of the ice? Yeah, probably because of the ice. Come on. There it goes. Oh, I guess it could have been exited here. There's a tower. So now go to Giant's Deep so I can get to the bottom. Down. There's the shuttle. I want Brittle Hollow or Timberheart. Oh, dang it. Okay, never mind. I guess I did want Timberheart. Or a hearth. I keep getting pulled by ghost matter. Not if you use your scout to detect it, you won't, you dumb idiot. You think I made that just so you could take pretty little pictures of trees? It has multiple uses. You do know you can use it as a light source, right? Source of love. Please tell me you knew that. The sun is going to supernova, by the way. Oh yeah, the observatory has an exhibit about it. Between you and me, I glossed over some of the finer details. Astrophysics is really more Hornfell's domain. Me? I'm here for the rocket science and the marshmallows. You're lucky I'm a time loop because otherwise I'd be super dead. And you're lucky I don't have you grounded for medical reasons because I have no idea what you're talking about. Okay, there we go. No, I'm good. Where would you even start on that? I guess like here? Found a dead Naomi in a spacesuit near the South Pole. I met a living Naomi named Solanum at the South Pole. The quantum moon is the eye of the universe's moon. At this location, the quantum moon becomes a reflection of the eye itself. The eye is likely the source of all macroscopic quantum phenomena in the solar system. Solanum wonders what would happen if a conscious observer were to enter the eye. So we got the Sunless City, and that's about it. Wait, this isn't the Sunless City. Sunless City is Hourglass Twins. Specifically, Ember Twin. Remember the suit. Ah, dang it. Ghost matter causes crystals, not the other way around. So this one is Eye Shrine District. coming over here. I feel like I've been here. Oh, right. Don't walk into the ghost matter. That's a terrible idea. Welcomed. We observed the source. We know it's the source. Be enter and open your mind. Oh, ship log updated. Yeah, called to us. Why won't it reveal itself? Why make it so different, difficult? Did the signal stop? Perhaps this isn't the guy's choice. Did the eye deliberately call out to us by sending the signal? We could be seeing meaning where there is none. The eye want to be found. Maybe it chose us. Maybe it didn't have to be us. Does that mean the eye is any less important, though? Is the eye natural or artificial? Maybe someone built it. The eye is older than the universe itself. Could be naturally occurring. Alright, how do I get out of here? Ah, there's a hole in the wall. Okay. Ghost matter nearby. Ugh. Then we got anglerfish observation duty. Switch back to shooting mode. That away. All right. Okay, so it could have just lit up here the whole time. That one goes up. That one is sand. That one is also sand, that one is also sand. This one is also sand. Is this the one that goes where I want it to go? Doesn't look like it. I forgot which one I wanted to get into in the first place. This one. Okay, so there is sand. And it's straight back. I think it is this one. Yeah. Who's been computing shuttle trajectories to the sun station? Don't worry, the station is in such a low stellar orbit, we've constructed a different, safer way to travel there from Ash Twin. That would be Pi. I told her we wouldn't be traveling there by shuttle, and that the sun station doesn't even have a landing pad, but she said she knew. It's a purely theoretical exercise on my part, Yarrow. Who doesn't love computing a good low stellar orbit shuttle trajectory? Pi, I look forward to working with you, but I'm also relieved it will be easy to return to the Ash Twin regularly. Stepping Stone Cave. The angler entrance, and there's an exit. Anglerfish study. The long growth protruding from its head is bioluminescent. Perhaps it used this growth to attract prey. A lure? Visually, the specimen appears to be the same species as the anglerfish in Dark Bramble. We don't believe it originated from this planet. The anglerfish's digestive tract suggests death by starvation. An update, Milleray. While I was here making sketches of the anglerfish, I observed the children I saw earlier playing here again. They've added a rule to their game that incorporates our research. It's wonderful. I'm entirely delighted. It's never too early to appreciate biology. Nice. Hello, Planter. There's gotta be something there I can do. I think Sol Station has already been eaten. Alright, I think I see a landing spot. And that works. Whew. Gravity is 9 non-existent on this thing. See you, panel. Timber Hearth Projection Stone. Friends in the Timber Hearth Mines, the last type of ore you sent us survives the longest in direct heat. Can you send us more of the same for additional testing? We're attempting to improve its durability, and our forge has already burned through everything you sent. We'll deliver more ore to Hollow's Lantern immediately. You must be fired up about crafting the Ash Twin Project's protective shell. Yes, the idea of an encasement that's supernova-proof, however briefly, has kindled my curiosity. My gratitude. I imagine we'll all have an updated estimate soon of how much ore is needed to seal off the Ash Twin project. Will it be more than we initially thought? It'll be significantly more. The smallest crack or opening in the protective shell would destroy everything. Increased solar activity detected. Increased volcanic activity detected. Location is now inhospitable. Evacuation recommended. Oh, it's just now inhospitable? Ah, yes, the mines. Well, I thought that the starry background type stuff of the Ash Twin Center looked familiar. It's the same stuff as in the Zero G Cave. Now where's Ash Twin? There it is. Hearth, and there's the one I need. Okay, that's the still functioning one, and here's the broken one. Three, two, one, go. Go fast. Oh, hey, I don't think I remember reading these. I have good news, Yarrow. The advanced warp core is ready to be installed in the central chamber of Ash Twin. I'm intrigued, love. Everyone here working on the Ash Twin project is excited to see it. Pi is beside herself with joy. No, it isn't. Everything well at the forge. Of course, durability can still be improved. Ignore her. Don't worry. Poke is only nervous. Right, I already got that at the black hole. Alright, turn off gravity. Timber hearth. My gratitude for the latest shipment. This will be the last we need. After we finish the shell that seals off the central chamber, we'll check to ensure there are no longer any physical entrances. Raimi and I will be checking the interior and the exterior for cracks. Our final safety check. This is exciting news. Can I offer an extra set of eyes for this final check, specifically mine? If my work here is complete, I'd be delighted to help. We'd be grateful if you would. The more eyes, the better, as the smallest flaw or opening in the shell that protects the Ash Twin project could lead to disaster. So I need gravity to put things down, got it. I've installed the mass inside the Ash Twin Project blocks. They look beautiful, although I do feel as if I'm being observed. It's comforting to know the statues will not pair until the project succeeds, otherwise I imagine the experience would be hard to endure. Ideally, they'll only need to activate once the project succeeds. As a safety measure, however, the statues will also activate in the event of equipment failure. They will? Why is that? If anything goes wrong with the Ash Twin Project, the statues and their masks will make us aware of the situation and enable us to fix it. Otherwise, it would be possible for us to remain permanently unaware of the problem. And thought of that, what a profoundly horrific fate that would be. To access the core while the Ash Twin is active. Removing the core will disable the Ash Twin project. Well, it's definitely too late to do anything else, so might as well watch it go off. The supernova goes off. Alright, church on the north side. Found something. Never mind. What do you have to? Star charts. Okay. Just saying hi. Well, I gotta wait for the ash tower to be unburied to go back in there. I don't want to talk to Gabbro right now. You know what? I will. I just won't talk to him about getting that meditation skill yet. I missed the planet entirely. He's on the other side, isn't he? Oh, there's an unknown. Maybe I never scanned Chert. Okay, nope, that's north. That explains it. Hey Tao. Nice weather we're having, huh? Wait, have I used that one before? I found something. Nice, what you got for me? Found the source of the time loop. Really? The Nomai carved out Ash Twin and built a time loop device inside? That is wild. Now I know what's causing the loop then. And if it's caused by a device, that much means it had to be switched on, huh? Right? Huh. Hey, what do you think would happen if you turned off the time loop? Like, there's a part of me that thinks maybe you shouldn't, well, with the sun being up at all. Then again, who wants to spend eternity being blown up by the sun? Well, I'm no time loop expert. I'm just gonna sit here and ponder the intricacies of time and space. Maybe take a nap too, if I feel like it. Hello, again. Found out what happened to the orbital probe cannon. Oh, I found Nelmite masks inside the Ash Twin project. You're saying the statues were made so memories could be sent back in time. I guess that makes sense, considering we both have our memories of every loop we've gone through. Wait, then it's just our memories being sent back in time to us, right? Then are we really experiencing multiple time loops or not? That's pretty deep. Like, maybe our consciousnesses have been through all these loops, but maybe our bodies haven't? Because technically, the loops never happened. Meaning we're receiving memories of things that will never happen to us. Cool, huh? I found your quantum poem. Oh yeah, the one in the woods. I remember writing that. Pretty fun, right? It works out to a good 24 poems. When I'm done exploring, I want to make some more quantum art. Maybe some kind of creature sculpture that just, like, shows up while your back is turned and scares the daylights out of you. I found out what happened to the Orbital Probe Cannon. Whoa, that's the cannon breaking out? It's kind of scary how much that sounds like something slate or feldspar would do. I'm pretty surprised the Nomai built something that actually broke. Come to think of it, though, broke might be the wrong word. Alright, so that's everything he's got. What? What's up with the air? Is it just too far away for a reading? How did I park it? The most annoying possible place I could have put it. Can I get up there? I guess I'll just sit at the campfire until the tornado launches this island into space again. At least I'm not trapped underneath it this time. Whoops. Ah, great. Now I can get into the ship. Come on, let me out. Let me out. Let me out. Come on. There we go. Autopilot, you do not get to put me into the sun, thank you. Okay, now you can readjust. What? Come on. Twins are unburied. Ugh, landing gear damaged. I'll deal with that later. Hazard. I went to guest. Three, four, five. Receive data, probe tracking module, 10 minutes until end of cycle. Wait at a safer distance this time and skip 10 minutes. Whoops, accidentally got sent back. Gotta wait for it to roll around again. Minutes until end of cycle transmission. Thank you. Volcanic testing site. Core samples from the Nomai mines on Timber Hearth were sent to this volcano for durability testing. The Nomai were trying to craft a, briefly, supernova-proof shell to encase the Ash Twin project. Even the smallest crack or opening in the protective shell would destroy everything. The Nomai traveled to the solar system in pursuit of a signal from something older than the universe itself. They named the source of this signal the Eye of the Universe. The adult Nomai were delighted to see the children incorporate their research into the game's rules. Alright. I don't see anything I'm missing except for maybe something that connects to the gravity cannon. I don't know. Anyway, apparently going into that black hole is supposed to do something. It didn't last time, but maybe it will this time. Oh, started behind me. Oh, that's Giant's Deep, isn't it? Oh, nope, that's the Quantum Moon. Secondary sun entrance. Ow. Ow. Ah, dang it. Cactus don't give oxygen, apparently. You destroyed the fabric of space-time? How? Okay, that was oxygen deprivation death, which means I probably have to go into the black hole again and do an entire another loop to get into the thingamajig. Black hole. Alright, stranger should be in this direction, I think. If I only spend like 10 minutes exploring the stranger, then I should be able to make it to the Ash Twin project by the time it's ready to go off. Oops, crud. Suit. Oh, right. Need to grab an artifact. The raft got too far away, didn't it? Dang it. Ow. No raft here either. Ow. Huh. I mean, this is another path for the river to go when the dam breaks, I guess. Fuel. Nope, dang it. Go this way to under the tower. Okay, so this is along with the portrait. So if I go into the other realm, turn on this fire and turn off these two, then this might activate. Wait, I thought I heard something. Huh, guess not. Right, put you there. Oop, wrong one. Dang. It was worth a shot. I think this may have been more than 10 minutes. Come on, hurry. All right, so it did work. Okay, so I have one more code. Bangle is quarter Saturn quarter star. All right, so there should be a slide reel projector down at the other section. Hey, it's a thing. Yeah, I remember that there's a broken house. Convenient lantern is convenient. Ah, I swear I hit the next slide button. Okay, so this is just the instructions on how to get in there. Can't remember the code for this one. Oh crud, there's no raft there. Ow. Oh. Ah, dang it, I can't escape. Maybe I can get out the other way. Okay, I'm gonna have to go for the damn elevator. I wonder if I can still reach it. Gonna have the damn burst. Probably not. Ah, crud. And there goes the tower. Ah, it's over anyway. Yeah, I don't think I can get up there. Alright, I think that code might be used at the church. Symbol room. A secret room filled with wooden containers marked with different symbols. Three of the containers are marked with glowing vault seals, but their contents have been burned away. I opened the container marked with the symbol of the burning of a burning slide reel and found a vertical sequence of symbols inside. Moon, Saturn, moon, star, star. Alright, so, give it 10 minutes and then flee. Gotta get out before the dam breaks. Is the front. No, this way is the front. Repair that cockpit. Whoop, dang it. Dang it. There we go, sheesh. I don't even want the artifact. Moon, Saturn, moon, star, star. Okay, it's up there. Open up the exit. Oh, wait, hold up. So there's something right there. Something right here. And I already found that by accident. Lantern, lantern. Okay. Oh, hello there. Dang. Okay. There we go. Well, that's certainly a thing that I'm going to have to figure out. My mouse with me. All right, I predict that the dam is about to break, so I better get out of here. Preferably without running into any walls. I am full body hurting. There we go. Back to full health. Ow. Frick. Man, it is much harder to steer when you don't have the sun's light. Ah, there it is. Oof, that's some information. Hidden Gorge still has more to find. There's an interface upstairs that can be used to line up symbols in a vertical sequence. Entering the correct sequence opens the path to a secret room behind the temple. I found a slide reel that shows the stranger's inhabitants removing all of the slide reels from their shelves, scanning each reel with a device, and incinerating specific slides as well as entire reels. Projection that seems to reveal a location somewhere within the stranger. A map I found in the abandoned temple reveals a secret location somewhere within the stranger. A reel I found in the slide burning room shows a container marked with a glowing symbol being handed to a shadowy figure. The lights are extinguished and the figure carries the container into a secret passage behind a mural of a large tree. Found a hidden slide reel that shows a container marked with a glowing symbol. Burned slide reels. Okay. Alright. Secret fireplace. Alright, there's the tower, there's the rest of the buildings, and it's just right there. Okay. Sheesh, how long has this thing been going? Okay, go up. Go up, go up, go up. Friggin' autopilot. You know that ship, the ship is a death trap, right? Well, yeah, it's a death trap. It's a really powerful death trap. What, you suddenly care about safety now? You suddenly care about safety now? Okay. So, should be able to find that slide burning room number 2, I think it was. Oh, frick it. Starboard hull damage. Which one is starboard? Should be over here. Why can't I get to it? There it goes. There it goes. Nice. Okay, can't do anything if it's not in the water. I think the issue was with the temple one was that I did not get all 3 of the map hints into the log somehow. There's the temple. So I need to go this way. Yeah, I think it's over here. Ah, dang it. Okay. There we go. Yeah, I remember trying to go this way and there being a dead end. So maybe before the dam breaks, there's actually something? Ah, yeah, there is. Okay, there's a lantern. Dang it. No? Oh. Well, that's easier. That isn't broken. And I don't want to walk all the way back to the observatory, so just go back down this secret tunnel. Grab the lantern that was conveniently here. Oh. So on that boat ride, there's a secret hidden hand statue. Oop, there goes the power. I think that means that the dam's gonna burst soon. I think I've got time to get to the Hidden Gorge, though. Moon, Saturn, Moon, Star, Star. Thank you. don't think I've ever gone to this house. Nope, can't get through there. So the door down here somewhere. There we go. Nice, slide reel. And nothing else. Okay, grab the slide reel. The building for slides. Gotta go grab the lantern out of the church. Ow. That's up and left from the entrance. Where's the out? I got lost already. There's the out. All right, to the slide burning church. Whoop, dang it. Damn. Okay, so that's the building that's in here, I think. Just dropping down to that. That I've already dealt with. Aha, ship log updated. And there's the grate that I have in fact gone through. I already grabbed that slide reel. I hope I can get onto the dam. Alright, definitely can't make that jump. It would be foolish of me to think that I might be able to make that jump. Frick. All right. One more quick jaunt to the outside of the stranger and should be able to get out of there before everything explodes. put on the suit. Which way is down? That way is down. Frick. Where's the thing? Alright, get back in the ship because I cannot find it. Oh, what? Ah, okay, that explains it. I was on the wrong side. Oh, this has gravity. Interesting. In case you hadn't figured it out. Oh, this is a hidden gorge. So I've got a way out for when the dam breaks. Okay, good. Yep, that was a thing in the slide. Come on, let me in. How do I manage to get these things stuck? Okay, there we go. Laboratory with three test chambers. The second chamber is badly damaged and can be entered through a hull breach in the side of the stranger. I saw a vision-like recording of someone picking up an artifact and going to sleep in front of a green fire. The rest of the vision was distorted and difficult to make out, but a flame seemed to appear inside the artifact. I found a slide reel that showed three experiments conducted with three different artifacts. The third experiment appears to have been a success. A projection that seems to reveal a secret location within the stranger. And that goes to that one. Secret fireplace. The reel I found in the slide burning room shows a container marked with a glowing symbol being handed to a shadowy figure. The lights are extinguished, and the figure carries the container down into a dark well. Several slides are burned and cannot be viewed. I found a hidden slide reel that shows a container. Room full of burned slide reels. Alright, so sealed vault, secret fireplace, secret well, secret mural. Should be the Whitehall Station. Dark Bramble. Terra Firma. Emberheart. Or, sorry, Ash Twin. The autopilot should be able to handle this. There's barely even a plan between us. Right, I forgot to refuel. All right. May as well get that signal reading on chert, since apparently I forgot to do that. Other side of the planet. Oh, no. Chert isn't the unknown one. Which one is unknown? Feldspar. Ah, I never visited Eskar. Pretty sure I already talked to her about that at some point. Or them. That's the interloper. There's Hearth. Battle Rock. Oh, hey, it's you. Is that you whistling? Probably. Where's this place? Dang. There's nothing to tell you about stuff. Signal identified, Esker. Rybeck, Gabbro, Chert, Feldspar. Quantum Moon, Cave Shard, Grove Shard, Museum Shard, Island Shard, Tower Shard. Okay. Stress Beacons, Escape Pod 1, Escape Pod 2, Escape Pod 3, Radio Tower. Deep Space Satellite. Ah, you know what? I never played with the kids, I guess. So I don't have Hide and Seek Radio. Ah, hello, Quantum Moon. I'm looking for Hearth, thank you. That way. I thought I heard your ship take off. Is your adventure only a short one? Any new dirt? Hoping to see Esker to tap trees next time they return from the Addle Rock. If they bring me lunar sap, I can attempt moonwine. Back already? Is everything okay? What are you doing back? Did you forget your spacesuit or something? Everything okay? Seems kind of early for you to be back from space. I'm good, actually. Okay, take care now. Hello, astronaut. You wanted to play hide and seek? Sure, let's play. Oh, you found me? So my hiding spot was super good. Identified Telfra. Identified Galena. I won? I'm happy. Thanks for playing with us. And I think that's all the signals. Oh wait, hold up. Hey, it's you. It's like said you're blasting off of your ship today. Hey, I'm still going. You better be. It's been forever since anyone launched into space. Wow, that's just time. Like the time the external fuel tanks exploded on re-entry. You'll be okay flying the big one, right? Eh, it's still mostly intact. Ugh. Ah, the elevator's all the way up there still. All right, nothing from you. And it has stopped putting sand up there. So I may or may not be too late. Does mean that I can just stand here, though. Yep, I'm too late. Made some decent progress in the DLC, though. I think I've thoroughly explored everything that wasn't in the dream world. And then it's just all sorts of timing stuff, like get that bridge at the start belt, or raft at the start available, then run all the way down to the next one so that you don't get absolutely hammered by the dam breaking, and then start doing stuff over there. Yeah, that didn't work. I think I'll call it there.